Softers, basically what we're going to be doing today is I have a friend's gun here. This is his AK. This one isn't mine. This one here belongs to Hot Wings Airsoft. He is on YouTube, so you can go over there and check out his channel. I'm doing him a favor today, and we're going to be installing RE-Tech internals here into his trigger box. So if everybody can please sit back and enjoy the video. But basically what we're going to be doing here first is, the first things first, is we're going to have to take out the trigger box. So let's get all this out the way. Alright, pop open your upper here, take out your recoil rod, pull out your bolt and your guide, like so. Alright, and there's your trigger box. Now to get the trigger box out, there's an Allen key with a grub screw that sits on top of your selector here. You're going to need to take that grub screw out. Alright, got the grub screw. Once that grip screw is out, you'll be able to take your selector off here. Move it around just a bit, it'll pop right off. Like so. Alright, next thing is next. There's a pin right here that sits in the front. You're going to want to pop this pin out. Like so. Okay, and you're going to want to take off your pistol grip, because the bolt that runs through your pistol grip actually bolts to your trigger box, so you're going to take this off. Alright, now once that's done, you're going to pop out your selector here in the back by pushing back on it, and then pulling it out, like so. Once that's done, you should be able to pull on the trigger. Now watch here on the mount side here, because you have springs and everything here that you're going to make sure that you don't lose. So basically, let me resituate the camera and we will get closer here and show you how it's all done. Alright, now that we got the trigger box and all removed from the AK here, this is basically what she'll look like. It's a two-piece trigger box with the hammer here, your sear here, here's your trigger. Here goes your firing pin, and your valve locker sits behind this plate here. This here is your blocker for your magazines, and your catch, your hammer catch. So, basically, let's move on, and basically what you're going to want to do is pull the trigger to lift up your hammer like so. There is a pin here. Okay, you're going to want to push this pin out and through, like so. You can see it's coming off the other side here. Here you go. Got the pin out. Like so. Once you do that, your hammer and sear will slide out. As you can see. Now make sure that you remember which way these springs go on, because you will have to put them back on the way they came out. Just make sure that the bend is always at the bottom, like so. They go on that way and not this way. So make sure of that. Take your springs off. Here there is a spring underneath your sear here. Okay, you're going to make sure you don't want to lose that. So you're going to want to push your bushing out here. And once you push your bushing out, you can take your sear and that sear spring out. Save the spring because you're going to need it to put the RE-Tech 1 in. Alright, there you go. That's the part. Now next what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take apart your front of your trigger box here, which includes your hammer and your firing pin. Basically what you're going to want to do next is take like a little pick like this and take out your firing pin spring here. like so. Put that to the side. Next, you're going to pop out your hammer spring. Your hammer pin, I'm sorry, like so. And then you're going to want to take your trigger box apart. Take out these two screws. Now, these screws are different sizes. Remember that the smaller one goes to the top and that the longer one goes to the bottom. Like so. As you can see, they are different sizes. Okay. Now, you want to take this plate off. When you take the plate off, be careful, because as you can see right here, your locker spring is in here. You don't want that locker spring to shoot off. And there is another spring that sits on your hammer, your firing pin here. You don't want to lose that neither. So when you take this off, just be careful. Make sure nothing goes shooting. Okay. Here's the plate. Here goes your locker for the AK. And the locker spring. Okay, next step is to remove your hammer. That pops right out like so. And then there goes your bushing for the hammer as well with the hammer spring. Alright, next you're going to take your firing pin out and the firing pin spring. You want to take out your blocker here like so. And then the spring and your firing pin should come right on out. Voila. And there goes the AK trigger box disassembled. Now this here you could take out as well, but there's no need for us to take this out just for the fact that we're not going to be replacing it with anything, so it could just stay right where it's at. Alright, let me get the RA Tech parts and we'll get back to putting these steel ones in. Alright, so basically the parts that we're going to be replacing here are the parts that you see in front of me here. The buddy of mine got the trigger set, not the trigger assembly. So basically with the trigger assembly you'll also get the steel valve locker here and the steel selector, as you see here. He only got the trigger set, so basically we're only going to be replacing the trigger, the sear, the hammer, and the firing pin. Basically, let's look at the difference here. This here's the stock firing pin for the AK, and this one here is the RA Tech steel one. So we can put this aside because that's getting replaced. This here is the stock sear. This one here is the RA Tech CNC steel sear. Alright, put that aside. That's getting replaced. This here is the RA Tech steel hammer. This here is the stock hammer. Alright, now RA Tech supplies you with a new bearing that comes with the hammer. So basically we're going to be getting the old bearing and the old hammer out the way here. And we got the steel trigger. This here is the steel one. This one here is the stock one. Alright. Now these can be a little finicky putting them back together. So if it takes me a second, just don't mind. I'm sorry, and I'll cut in or cut out if need be. But basically, let's get this puppy back together. Alright. What we're going to do is we're going to start off with the hammer, basically. We're going to put the spring back inside the hammer, which is here. Pop out our bearing. Okay. Put our spring in like so, and then slide your bearing in. The bearing will hold the spring in, so there's no worries there. Like so. Alright. Take our hammer, place our hammer back in. Push the locker forward so the hammer slides in. And push it down. And when you push the hammer down, the locker will hold the hammer in place. But just make sure it does not pop out. Because it has a tendency to slide out if you do bump it or whatnot. So just be careful with that. Next, we're going to be putting in our firing pin and pin spring. So let's put our pin spring in here. This is the pin spring. It goes back in like so. and it sits on top of the hammer. Get a little bump, push that spring in there. Like so. Now I found out that the easiest way to put your firing pin back in is to, first of all, it goes in this way, is to set it on top, like so, and that spring goes up and under the firing pin, like so, and set it in place. Now make sure you hold this in place. You're going to need to hold it in place because that spring has a tendency to push it out. As you can see, it's moving already. So make sure you hold that in place. Put your magazine catch back in there. Alright, now we're going to put this down like this for now. Okay, so it holds it in place. And I found out that the best way to put your valve locker back in is to put it in this way. Put your spring in first. And then your valve locker like so. Okay. Just like that. Spring in first, then your valve locker. Alright, we're going to pick this back up. Like so. And then put this baby back in there. Now this part here could be a little bit finicky. So just give me 1 second and bear with me. This is hard to do on camera. We're gonna try this one more time. Go grab my little pick here, push down on the valve locker. So there you go, pop back into place, and there you go. Now we just have to put our screws back in, which are here. Remember, the long one goes toward the bottom. And the short one goes at the top. Alright, well, there you go. That's all together now. Basically, what we're going to do now is put our locker spring back in here for our firing pin. Like so. As you see, that pops right back in there. And next, we're going to put our sear and trigger back in. Basically, to do that, you're going to release your hammer. Like so. Okay. Put that there. Now, this here is the steel hammer and the steel sear. You're going to take your sear spring, put it back underneath. Like so. Drop it inside your hammer. And then put your bearing back in. Like so. Okay. Next, you're going to put your springs back in. Now remember, the bent part goes on the bottom. Like so. And do the same with the other side. And then we're going to just drop it right in our trigger box here, which can be a little bit tedious. Alright. Seems to be back in there. And then put our pin back in. So, There you go. Trigger's in. Put a pin back into our hammer. Like so. There you go. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Alright, now that we got the trigger assembly all together, like so. Okay. We're going to drop it back into the gun here and see how she works. So basically, just drop her back in. Like so. She's sitting in there good. We're going to put the pin back in first. Next, we're going to do our grip. Now, once you put the grip back on, hold it with your finger on the inside so the trigger box won't move and you can just tighten it down. It makes it easier too. This way it's just not moving around on you and you don't risk breaking anything. So, alright, tighten it down. I'm going to drop our selector back in. So, first I'll just switch back in. And then drop our grip screw back in. Alright, good to go. Let me tighten it. It's gonna be tighter. I don't have it in there right. Push that in some more. There we go. Now she's in there good. Now we can tighten our grub screw down. Like so. Now she's solid. Good deal. Put our bolt back in. Like so. And let's give her a shot. Make sure she works. We have a... turn it off this way. We can dry fire. Single. Full auto. Good to go. Alright everybody, well I hope you seen how it is, and hope you enjoyed the video, and hope this is helpful to many people who want to take apart the trigger box and install some new RA Tech stuff, or just to take it apart and maintain it. If you have any questions, please let me know, and as always, stay true.